Alright, so I mentioned in the first lesson that every individual lesson will cover a specific topic. These range from passwords to encryption to pseudonyms, VPNs, Tor, and much more. To give you a heads up, every lesson is broken down more or less as follows. First, there's a promo. Speaking of, you know, promos don't always have to be promoting merchandise and all that typical stuff. Being a part of our community is just as important. We have a super fun Discord server, a brand new Telegram channel, and group Minds, and for all you noobs, I do have Instagram, sadly. That's all. Enjoy the rest of the lesson. I'll start with the basics. What you need to know. This will be an introduction to the topic. Then, there's the big no-nos. Not using the same password for every website, the easy things that you should be implementing no matter who you are. Then it will start to get a little bit more advanced. I may tell you to use a password manager to create more secure and unique passwords for websites. Then I will go to the very advanced side of things where I'm going to recommend not using cloud-based password managers because you don't own your keys, things that are in general more extreme. Now, you might have noticed the colors were changing behind me. As the lesson gets more and more advanced, the color will change along with it. Green is the easy stuff, red is the advanced stuff, yellow is in the middle, and black is extreme. Every lesson will be set up this way to better allow you to draw a line. A line between what you may ask, well, I like to call it the convenience line. In general, the more private and secure you wish to become, the more time and work you're going to have to put in. There's just no way around this. It's just like riding a bike. You can have zero security protection for your bike and very quickly be able to grab it, hop on, and ride away. Very convenient indeed. Now, let's say you put a simple lock on it that requires a key. Well, now you have to carry the lock on you everywhere, you have to lock your bike every time you stop, and you have to make sure you don't lose the key. Convenience has dropped significantly, but your security has gone up. Now let's say you get a heavy-duty lock that requires an 8-digit PIN in addition to a key. I don't know if they make that, but let's assume it's a thing. The convenience has dropped even more with a slight bump in security. So yes, there are very commonly diminishing returns when it comes to security and privacy. At the end of the day, most of us are okay sacrificing privacy and security for convenience, and we need to turn this around. Neil Postman, an American author, stated, "It is a mistake to suppose that any technological innovation has a one-sided effect. Every technology is both a burden and a blessing. We have lost power over our lives because we want to enjoy the convenience offered to us. We are open to dealing with anyone who has a way of bringing us something quickly, conveniently, and/or cheaply, but in exchange for little information and freedom. We will all draw our lines in different areas, and it's important for us to understand our boundaries. Some things in this course will seem extreme to some and introductory to others. Be aware of your boundaries and how different people have different lines." Once again, every lesson will start with the basics and progressively get less and less convenient, and this is where you have to draw a line. I am sure that not everyone watching this course will follow everything I discussed to the max, and that is totally okay. This course is set up to be used by anybody, no matter who you are, so I now grant you the ability to draw your own line. Thank you for being here, and see you in the next lesson.